Good evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. And today I am going to do something completely different. Just a quick background. I think, as you can imagine, doing whiskey reviews can be quite expensive. It's quite a young channel. And I think in the last six, seven months, I did about 140 reviews. And of course, that means that you have to buy 140 bottles of whiskey in order to do the reviews. Now, early on, I also realized that that is definitely not affordable. And I started to buy some sample bottles. And I was also donated some samples from fellow YouTube reviewers, which I am very grateful for. The Whiskey Trials, Alan Wilson as well from the Whiskey Friend has always tried to help me with some samples, and I'm very grateful for them. So expensive, yeah. Especially if you want to review something that you've never tasted before. And you buy a big bottle of it, you try to sample of it, taste it to see if you like it, and then realize you don't really like it. And for me, it's simple. If I review it, I would like to drink it afterwards. So early on, I started also buying samples, but I am in Belgium. And it's very difficult to find decent samples. So in the last couple of months, I found a small little shop, online store in Holland, and I could buy some samples, but it was quite a limited list. And I quickly went through all the samples that they had that I really wanted to try. Also made some mistakes and bought some real bad ones. And that for me was an excellent idea of buying samples, because in the end, if you buy something you don't like it, then of course you haven't wasted a lot of money. So also in the beginning, I bought some big bottles, which I tasted, and I realized that there's no way that I am going to endorse a bottle like that on my YouTube channel, because it was just not good enough for me. So that's a lesson that I've learned before. And of course, people are not interested in having a look at the old bottle that's nobody's interested in seeing anyway. So a little bit of a waste of time and a waste of effort. So with that, I actually found a store here in Belgium, maybe not the cheapest store. I was a little bit surprised on delivery cost, but I think if you go for the big box and buy as many samples as that you can at one time, took a while, almost a week for them to deliver it. And today they are deliver it, and tonight I'm going to do something that I never thought I'm going to do, is to give you a little bit of a preview on the whiskeys that's going to be reviewed in the next couple of months. And a nice big box that arrived, and I'm quite excited to see what the samples look like, because I have no idea. I don't show you any pictures of the samples. So I got my nice trusty Swiss knife, some documentation on the box, not sure what is in it. So you're gonna discover with me what it looks like. It seems to be well packaged, a lot of paper, a little bit of a bubble wrap, some documentation with a list of all the samples and another box, a little bit a box within a box. So if you get the knife out again, some more paper. Ah, and now we get to the favorite part. And I'm quite excited. It's quite a decent RAM. And with just a number on it. So I think if you want to do blind tastings, I think this is going to be fantastic. Get the wife or a friend or anybody to put the samples in front of you with the number, and of course you can do a fantastic blind tasting. I don't think I am going to do that soon, but I think that's also something that you can then look at in the future to do some blind tasting. Luckily, they did print me not very gracious, but they did print me the key to everything. So I'm just going to give you a quick rundown of what I bought and what to look for in the future. So sample number two, nice light color, and they tell me number two is Aaron, 10-year-old, bottled at 46% ABV. And that's my dog thinking that the papers is a present for her. So the next sample, number seven, also quite light in color. And number seven, they tell me it is a Benriach 10-year-old. So I think this is bottled at 43%. And I think that is just a normal Benriach. This is not a Curiositas. Next one, number five, also quite light in color. And the number five is going to be the Okintosh 40% ABV. Quite looking forward to that. Never had one, so it's going to be my first. The next one, getting a little bit darker in color, number 11. It is the Glen Scotia double cask, bottled at 40% ABV. Looking forward to this one. I've heard so many good things about Glen Scotia, and looking forward to see what the fuss is all about, and if it's something that I would also like. So looking forward to that. Next one, number three, also a light one. So I did pick all the light ones, and of course there's plenty more at the shop. They sent me a huge Excel spreadsheet with literally hundreds of bottles that you can get samples for. I think it's a fantastic idea. So the next one that I have is number three on the list, and that is the Aaron Barrel Reserve, bottled at 43%. There's quite a little bit of sediment in this one. I'm not sure why that is, but a little bit of a concern, but we'll keep an eye on that one. Next one, number nine on the list, it's the Deanston, bottled at 46% ABV. Quite a light, also a little bit of a sediment, so probably no filtration. A little bit of a concern as well. Next one, nice dark color to it. Quite excited to see what it is. Number four, Aaron Sherry casks. So I did buy some of the Aaron's. I do like a good Aaron. So also something that I will be looking forward to. Next one, number 10 on the list. And this is the Glen Scotia 15-year-old, bottled at 46% ABV. And I think this is the one that I'm going to start off with. Really looking forward to this one. I saw some discussions around the Glen Scotia products. So I, in my mind, when I bought this online, I think this is the one that really stood out for me that I need to try. And of course, this is definitely going to be the first review, and it will be maybe either today or tomorrow, I will put this one on YouTube. Some more to go. Number 12, also quite a light one in color. And it is the Glendronach peated, bottled at 40% ABV. Now, for me, the funny thing is that yesterday, actually, I got a comment on one of my videos, and I was asked about this Glendronach peated. So, yeah, definitely second probably on the list to see what the fuss is all about. I used to love Glendronach when Billy Walker was still there. I like the integrity of the whole range, but I think things are changing a little bit in Glendronach, so maybe it's going to fall to the wayside, I'm not sure. So, but maybe the peated one will change my mind. I'm used to Glendronach as a sherry cask finish type of whiskey, so going to be my first peated one from the Glendronach range. The next one, number 13, also nice color to it. I like a little bit of a, not always the dark ones. And this is also a Glendronach, and this is the Highland. Glendronach Highland, bottled at 40% ABV, probably butchering that name, but I will try to find out the correct pronunciation of it. And a couple more to go. I also have number 8, again, quite light, very clear as well, so happy with this one. And it is the Bowman, our number 1, it says here on the list, bottled at 40% ABV, so a little bit of a young, smoky one. I do like the Bowmans. I tried quite a number of them, the 25-year-old, the 18-year-old, the 12-year-old. So looking forward to a little bit of a smoke in the next couple of days. Two more to go. Number 1 on the list, and that is going to be Aberfeldy, 40%, 12-year-old. And the last one on the list, number 6, a little bit darker in color. And this is going to be the Belvini Double Wood, 40%, 12-year-old. So that is all the whiskies that I bought online. So in all, I have 13 samples, and I'm quite happy with all the samples. Cost-wise, range from anything from €4.50 till about 10, €15 for a sample. I opted, I think the most expensive that I one that I bought was about, I think it was €7.50, something like that. So for me, that makes economical sense, so that I can buy something, taste it. If I like it, I buy a big bottle. If I don't like it, it's €4.50, €5 that it's gone. But at least I can put it on the, tick the box and say I tried it, liked it or not. So that is the samples. That is the future for my YouTube channel. I am quite happy with it. And thanks for the people that sent me these ones. I'm quite happy with the service, although it did take a week, but I'm a patient man. So thank you very much for watching. Let me in a give me a little bit of a comment. Where do you buy your samples in Europe? Do you think it's a good idea to buy samples before you commit to a big bottle? And let's talk whiskey. So thank you very much for watching, and I see you next time. Cheers.